Don't talk, just listen. I'm sorry what I did to Compton. I couldn't help it. Don't know why I had to stab her. I am so upset about it. I keep getting drunk every night. I can't believe it. It's a big dream. I can't think of being locked up. If I get locked up, I'd kill myself. I'd rather kill myself than get locked up. I'll try not to kill anybody else.
Play your emergency.
Please don't talk, just listen. I'm sorry I killed that girl. I stabbed her 40 times. Kimberly Compton was the first one. Oh, my faith. Oh, I don't know what's the matter with me. I'm sick.
Stefani wanted to talk to some St. Paul policeman and clear the slate.
Okay, Paul. You have the rights to protection against self-incrimination.
Paskett and his partner, Keith Mortensen, drive up to the Oak Park Heights Correctional Facility for a sit-down with Stefani and perhaps a chance to finally close the books on Kim Compton and Karen Potek.
Well, with Karen Potek, he says he's driving down an alley. He sees this girl behind the bar, I believe. She doesn't have a jacket on. He stops, offers her, you know, lets her get into the car to warm up, is what he tells us.
She got in my car, and I gave her my jacket and told her, I said, the heat will be on in a minute. I said, I had to clean some of the ice off the windshield.
Do you remember where you hit her with the tire iron, Paul? Did you hit her one time, two times?
Must have been about 30 times, but I mean, I good 20 times, I think, about.
Were you swinging it this way, or did you poke her with it? Or
no, I don't think I poked her. No. I remember it hit her mainly on the forehead, on the cheek, and the jaw. Mouth, and the top of the head. And I think it was only about 10 times, but then I know she must really be hurting in that, you know, the steel bar like that.
Is he insane? No. Is he different than most people that you see? Yes. And as he relived these incidents, he dropped back into the same voice and same person that he was 20-some years ago.
I was even hurt when I went back to the car. God, there's going like this. I mean, and that's what I made me want to go to the phone. I mean, I really wanted to help her. My mind started clearing up. What are you doing? You had a chance to make another friend that could be yelling at myself. You like to make friends.
6 months after the attack on Karen Potek, Stefani confesses he walked into a local diner and made another friend, 18-year-old Kimberly Compton.
This gal was sitting like one or two seats away from him, and she had just gotten in town, and he strikes up a conversation with her and learns that she had just gotten off the bus.
And then that's when she started telling me where she was from, in Wisconsin and all that. And I says, well, say, why don't you, I'm not even thinking about hurting right now. I said, hey, why don't you let me show you downtown?
According to Stefani, Kimberly Compton agreed to go for a ride and see the sights of St. Paul at night.
I said, yeah, I want to show you something. There's really a nice view over here. I mean, you see the nice river. I think I mentioned somebody you can probably have something to tell your parents about them.
So he uses the pretense of the view. They get out of the car, and he says he parks the car in the bushes.
As I walked out of the car, I carried my knife with me. I had every intention to hurt me. We laid down in the grass, and I remember opening up her bra and everything. I'm just feeling it. So, and he just starts stabbing her.